Hi guys, and welcome to another Bootstrap for Web Design video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, in our last video, we answered somebody's question about how to make a transparent background for your navbar here. But I wanted to point out the problem that you may have when you're scrolling up. You're going to lose that when it goes over something white, or the writing goes behind it. It's going to make it kind of real difficult to read. As you can see, it's still actually there. But, you know, it's not really what you want. Because if you can't see it, although people can click on it, they're not going to know it's there. So to alleviate that problem, I find a good idea is to put a gradient behind the navbar that starts off at a dark color. Maybe you can get the color of your image, if you will, and then goes to a transparent color. I'm just going to use black for this demonstration. So what I'm going to do is, at the moment, we've got a transparent background going on here. Let's just change that to black. Got to put the important class behind it to actually make it work, as we said in the last video. Now let's take this black. I'm going to take the opacity or opacity just to show you. We've now got a black navbar up there. Let's take this opacity all the way down. And just copy that number there, which is four zeros. Now what we want to do, we want to go back to our CSS. Let's just close that out. Now if we go back to our brackets software, here's our background. I'm going to just say background rather than background color. And here I'm going to write linear dash gradient. And open some round brackets. Inside there, we want to put the two colors that we've got. A linear just means it's going in a straight line. You can have diagonal, you can have circular ones. Linear just means it's going in a straight line, whether it's top to bottom or left to right. By default, it's top to bottom, I believe. I hope, because if it's not, this isn't going to work. And let's paste in, let's put our first color in, which was black, which is 000. And then you just put a comma in and put in your second color, which was 0000. When there's only three, if it's six of all the same, you only need to put in three. And let's put a little semicolon in after that. Let's use important with that to make it work, and a semicolon. Save that, Control S, back to the site. And refresh. There we go. And as you can see, we've now got a gradient. It starts off dark at the top and it's transparent at the bottom. And you can still see your image through it, which is what you want. To my mind, there's a bit too much of the writing seeping through there. That might be fine for you, but you can adjust this, the percentages of the transparent and the black. And to do that, if we go back to our CSS, just after your color there, give it a space, and let's say, I'm guessing, 30%. Save that, Control S, back to the site, refresh, scroll down to where we can actually see it. That sort of made it a little bit darker. And like with most things, let's just use our Chrome Inspector I'm using Google Chrome. I just right clicked and hit inspect, and we want to get the, here's the actual bit that we wanted, background dark, where we've put that code there. Let's highlight that 30%, just the 30 itself, not the percent. Then you can scroll up and down with your mouse wheel, and as I scroll up and down, you see that black's getting more as I go up and gets less as I go down. So you can just put it where you actually want it. Let's scroll up. I want it fairly. I want that to be very visible and very easy to read. There we go. That's pretty good. Now you can still see your image behind it. But when you scroll down, still see a little bit of writing going through it, which is fine, but these are really obvious, so you can really obviously get those going. So that sort of achieved that purpose. But like I say, put your percentage in and get it how you want it. So there you have it. That's how to put a semi-transparent gradient behind the nav bar of your Bootstrap 4 site. And of course that CSS will work in any HTML site or a WordPress site too. Obviously you may need to create a child theme if you're using WordPress. So I hope that's been useful to you. If it has, please like and subscribe to the channel. If you're interested in web development, take one of our web development courses below. We've got some huge discounts for our YouTube subscribers. There's also some great free courses down there, so have a look. Once again, this has been Jamie with System22 on webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.